he is done with Stride Pro Wrestling. And if B-Rad does not win this match tonight, he's out of here. That being said, weighing in at 200 pounds and hailing from Malibu, Illinois, this is B-Rad.
Agreed to this career-ending match, all right?
You didn't get your
career-ending match. You guys who forced me into this.
You got
that being said, I don't even know if Magnifico is even here tonight.
He is.
I haven't even seen him.
There's only one way to find out. Do we want to find out if El Magnifico is here tonight?
No!
How about we start? Olé!
Friends, you heard it off the top here. Should B-Rad not win this match, he's done here at Stride Pro Wrestling. Jose Magnifico, the opponent. In Stride Pro Wrestling. Time will tell as B-Rad faces Jose Magnifico. B-Rad, by the way, a trainee here at the Stride Pro Academy, a graduate, and a big chop right across the chest. B-Rad also the former legacy champion. And ouch! Jose Magnifico also a holder of that championship. Snap mare. B-Rad blinded with his shirt over his face. Magnifico quickly goes for a cover, but immediately B-Rad able to roll out of it. B-Rad is literally fighting for his career right now. Begging for mercy. Will Magnifico make a wish? B-Rad is hurting. Cover, only a one count though. Only a one count. B-Rad moving into the corner now. Oh, very wisely using Magnifico's own momentum against him and now trying to suffocate him into that turnbuckle. Referee though, getting in there and counting. Oh, and look at that. Magnifico fighting back now. Another snap mare. Goes for the cover. Doesn't hook a leg though. Only gets a one count. Front face lock by B-Rad onto El Magnifico. Magnifico with a nice takedown. And look at that. Throwing some close fist. Magnifico a little more aggressive too in this matchup.
Yeah.
The Stride powers that be, determining that if B-Rad does not win, because he's done a lot of complaining, he's talked a lot of smack here lately about Stride, not only in the ring, but on social media, and I think that folks have had enough, and if he doesn't want to be here, he doesn't have to be here, and if he loses this match, he is gone from Stride. Now he's got that chin lock on Jose Magnifico. And a big clubbing forearm across the back. Oh! And a knee right into the side of those ribs. Oh, nonchalant. You're not going to beat a veteran like Jose Magnifico like that. B-Rad a little overzealous, a little overconfident, if you will, in his abilities. And I think he's going for the mask. I don't know what the purpose of unmasking Magnifico would be. And Magnifico protecting that mask. B-Rad sent into the corner and a shoulder block. But Magnifico a bit staggering too. Look at this. Charges in with a clothesline. A reversal. Big headbutt from B-Rad. And again, going after the mask. I don't know what the motivation for that is. Risking getting disqualified, though, because he does have him pinned in that corner as well. Now a condescending conversation between B-Rad and the referee. And B-Rad now charging back in. No one home this time. Snap there. And Magnifico. Nicely done there as he takes the wind out of B-Rad's sails, hooks the leg, but only a two count. And there's a knee into the back. Surfboard. It's gonna hurt him here. Working on those shoulders and those arms. He's in a lot of pain right now. A lot of pain. Not giving up though. B-Rad knows if he says I quit here, he's done. Signing his own termination, if you will. And now rubbing the face into the mat is El Magnifico. Oh! And a smack on the bottom. And that's really going to set B-Rad off. As B-Rad seeking comfort now from one of our fans in the front row. And B-Rad now taking a hike. Oh, but he gets caught. And Magnifico, oh! He missed, and Magnifico's hand bounced right off of that corner steel post. Good Lord. Risking a count out here. Oh, look at that. He drops him right across the top rope, throat first. And another big chop right across the chest. There's a drop kick. B-Rad is staggering. A cover. Will it be enough? No, B-Rad. Career in the balance here. And again, going after the mask. There's no... I don't understand this. He's distracted with the mask. He got it. He got it, but look at that. Magnifico. This isn't his first rodeo. Nicely done here. Look at this. Look at this. Big Samoan drop, hooks the leg. Will it be enough? It is, folks.
The winner of this match, Jose Magnifico. Therefore, it is bye-bye,
Payton Ayers, and Chambers, by the way, also wrestles, as we all know by this point, as Dexter Roswell, Bloody Dexter. You're never really sure what incarnation of Roswell or Chambers, whatever you're going to get. He's a man of many characters. And a waistlock now. Payton Ayers, a big, big man, 300 pounds, a monster, going through the training here, was a former protege of the Stride Pro Wrestling heavyweight champion, Ryzer, who we'll be hearing from a little later tonight. But Ayers has clearly started carving his own path here. A very big man, a powerful man. I don't know that he knows his own abilities and strength. Look at this. Look at this example right there. Stops Chambers right in his path. Oh, but Chambers now. Look at that. Some fancy footwork there. And the big man is reeling early on. But look at that, though. Just throws him like a rag doll. And a big uppercut. Chambers sent into the far corner now and charging in. Oh, but a knee or a foot right to that knee. And Roswell, or I'm sorry, Chambers, very wisely chopping the big man down to size. This is exactly what he needs to do to gain an advantage against someone the size and the power. Take that wheel out if you can, but look at that. Look at that, that strength still early into this matchup, and a big knee lift and knocks Chambers to the floor here at the Stride Arena. And look at that, he's just kind of waiting, biding his time, giving Chambers an opportunity to catch his breath, which is sportsmanlike, I suppose, but kind of out of character. Look at this. Going to bring him in the hard way. And Chambers crashes to the mat. Hook of the leg. Only a one count. And Luke Chambers now struggling. And look at that. That's 300 pounds on you. Draped over that middle rope.
Come on, you know better.
That is not going to be good or anybody involved. Oh, and a stomp. And look, just stomping relentlessly, ruthlessly. Oh, now standing on the chest of Luke Chambers. Man, I'm telling you, Payton Ayers risking a disqualification here, not listening to the referee. And just brutalizing Luke Chambers, but Chambers now mounting another comeback, but a big clubbing forearm from the big man. Stops Chambers in his tracks one more time. Front face lock now, setting him up for a suplex. Up high, and coming down. Hooks the leg. Kick out at two, though. Luke Chambers now stuck in a chin lock here by the big man, and the referee's going to check to make sure that Payton Ayers has not slipped that under the chin and formed a chokehold or anything. Oh, and a big boot to the midsection. Chambers now, oh, and a boot to the face. Oh, but stopped right in his tracks, right square in the middle of that ring. Look at this. Hooks the leg this time. That could be it. Chambers rolls out to the floor. Probably a wise decision on his part. Catch your breath. Take that 10-second break. Get that breather. And again, the relentlessness of Payton Ayers, as he's now stalking Luke Chambers out here on the floor of the Stride Arena. Sent head first into that apron. Uh-oh. This is not good! Oh! Luke Chambers with the wherewithal to move out of the way, and that just jammed the knee of Payton Ayers, and these two are battling it out still. Breaking that count, though, so there will be no count out here. And Luke's going to work on that knee. This may have turned the tide of this match into the favor of Luke Chambers, but I think Payton realizes that and is fighting now to stay in this match to keep things going here. That knee jammed when he kicked the steel turn, out there. And look at that, pounding those fists into the forehead of Luke Chambers. There's another one. Referee is warning Payton Ayers about the punches. Oh, a miss. He went for that big boot, and look at that. Chambers now fighting back. He's had enough. And a drop kick to the knee. Sling blade. Can he get the big man? Goes for the cover and hooks the leg. Referee only counts two, though, as Payton Ayers with a big, powerful kick out. He's telling me this guy is not ready to be done. Side headlock now. Chambers gets caught and drove right into that corner and several shoulders to the midsection. That's going to take more steam out of Luke Chambers. I can tell you that as he's squashed into the corner as well. Sent into the far side. That spine just bouncing off the turnbuckles, but Chambers able to move out of the way. Sent over the top. And he drops that throat across the top rope. And Chambers now insisting that he's gonna fly high. He's going up, folks. He's going up.
Come on, get back in.
Come on.
Yeah. Payton Ayers. Now he's taunting Payton Ayers to get up, challenging him. Oh, and Chambers misses the high cross body. Oh, look at that! That could do it. That could do it. That's enough.
That is enough.
The winner of this match, Payton Ayers!
at this time, please help me welcome the Stride Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion, Ryzer! Since winning the Stride Pro Wrestling Heavyweight title, you have defended this in ladder matches against Monster of Men, Jay Spade, Dalton Anthony last month, 1 month ago. And after you got the victory in that matchup, Heath Hatton makes his return. How are you physically and how are you mentally after that attack?
Well, Kevin, I made a full recovery. I feel great. I feel great physically. I just can't understand. I just can't understand why
I really have you talked to him? I know that, you know, he hadn't, it's no secret, has trained a lot of the men that have competed in this ring, you included in that. Has he reached out to you since that attack?
No, I haven't heard a word since that's happened. I haven't heard a peep of any news about Heath Hatton since that happened. And I haven't heard from him in a long time since before that.
He's not really been around a whole lot here, so... If you were here tonight, what would you say to him?
Well, if I saw Heath Hatton right now, I would want to punch his face in. So, what I wanted to do is I want Heath Hatton to come out here right now, face me man to man, and give me a reason why he thinks he needs to sneak up behind me to attack me when this is Heath Hatton that has been to the WWE, that has been to OVW, that has been wrestling all around the world for all these years, and for some reason he thinks he has to sneak behind me and attack me from behind. I want an explanation. I want Heath Hatton face to face, man to man, in this ring right now.
Let me introduce myself. I was hired by Heath Hatton. My name is Superstar Billy Ray. I manage superstars. Just like you said a minute ago, Heath Hatton, WWE, OVW, all around the world. That's why he's not coming out here to give you any explanation.
Okay, let me get this straight. So he hires you since he's such a superstar. First off, that's a big mistake. Secondly here, he thinks he's, you know, better than me, better than everybody else that shows up here, better than the people sitting in the crowd, that he can't come out and give the people an appearance.
Like I said, he's a superstar. You're a nobody.
Okay, that's very convenient. He thinks he's a superstar, so he can't come out here and face me man to man. You know, like you said, he's been around the world, and... You know, I love this business. I'm only here for two reasons. That's because I love to wrestle, and I love entertaining these fans in the crowd. Yeah!
And that's one of your problems. Don't you know the money is the root of this business? The money, the championships. That's what makes a superstar.
Okay, well, then I'm a nobody. Please tell me why. Give me a clue as to why I'm Stride Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship Belly Ray.
You're lucky.
I'm lucky. I'm lucky. I'll tell you who's lucky. Heath Hatton is lucky he's not here right now in this ring, so I can kick his teeth down his throat.
Oh, he's here? He's in the building. He's just not going to come out here and face you.
I understand. Okay. Alright, we all know. But I'll tell you what, since Heath Hatton is busy playing pickup basketball with some third graders, or maybe making some TikToks with his kids. Or maybe he's at the store picking up some Just for Men for that great beard. Whatever it may be, superstar Billy Ray, give me a yes or no. Is he going to face me tonight? Is he going to come face me man to man?
Like I said, he's not going to come out here right now. He owes you no explanation.
All right. Well, if that's the case, superstar, then why don't you just point me in the direction where your house is so I know which direction to kick your ass.
I'm just a spokesperson. I represent superstars.
Boo.
I'm not in wrestling gear.
Boo.
Okay, yes, I see that you are in maternity clothes. You're not in wrestling gear. I mean, you can go waddle yourself back to the back. Get in your gear. I'd be happy to help.
You know, I manage not only Heath Hatton, I manage other guys as well. In fact, I know a couple guys in the back, just like almost anybody in the back, would be willing to team up with Heath Hatton because they're all after one thing, and that's what you got on your shoulder. I don't think you could find two guys.
What?
Team help you out. So.
Yes, he could.
Yes, he could. Yeah, he could.
I mean, if you find two guys, I'm sure I could put my two guys plus Heath together, and they could just mop the floor with you.
Okay. Well, since you're not interested in throwing down with Ryzer, Heath Hatton isn't going to face me man to man, you know. You go find two partners. Being a champion has its perks. I got some buddies in the back. And we're gonna wreck you. I'm gonna stick my boots so far up Heath Hatton's butt, the sweat on my knee is going to quench his thirst.
You know, if you find two guys, we're in.
I'm in.
Alrighty, guys, you heard it. Later tonight, it's gonna be Ryzer and two partners against Heath Hatton and two partners, so stick around for that.
Dalton Anthony facing off against Playboy Paul Rose as a mutual show of respect there, shaking hands. Rose, a relative newcomer to Stride Pro Wrestling, but not a newcomer to the world of wrestling here in Southern Illinois, as he has been a part of All-American Pro Wrestling. We actually saw Playboy 2 years ago. I can't believe it's been 2 years already at AAPW Resurrection. And we heard earlier, apparently Heath Hatton and two partners will be facing off against Ryzer and two partners in our main event. Be sure to stick around for that, as Dalton Anthony working the headlock now and now into an arm wringer on Rose. Rose working to get out of that. A takedown, very nicely done. And now Rose holding on very tightly to the head of Dalton Anthony, but sent off the ropes, but it's Anthony that goes down. Leapfrog. drag. Whoa. And Rose repeats it there and goes for a quick cover. Not enough, though. And an elbow drop right to the small of the back of Dalton Anthony. Former Stride Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champion with Jay Spade. Of course, they have a very tumultuous relationship right now, to say the least. Spade suspended for his actions very recently here in Stride Pro Wrestling. A running forearm by Rose sends Dalton into the corner. Charges but misses, and Dalton Anthony now kicks Rose in a shoulder to the midsection. Rolls him up, schoolboy style. Drop kick there, and hooks the leg. Didn't have all of his weight on top of Playboy, though. Look at this. Chin lock. As Dalton now fighting to stay a part of this. Big elbow and a snapmare now. Oh, and a big kick. And there's a second one. One to the back, one to the chest. Hooks the leg. Not enough there. And Dalton now in trouble. Fans chanting Dalton's name here. And a jawbreaker on Rose. Oh, and a big kick. Oh, and a second one follows it up. Quickly goes for a cover. But Rose is able to kick out. Oh, jawbreaker and a clothesline. Second one. Big headbutt from Paul Rose. Dalton's in trouble right now, folks. Look at this. Oh, the referee gets crunched. Referee Kevin McCleary taken out. And what is Dalton Anthony doing? Nicely done. Plants Paul Rose, but no referee to make the count here. McCleary is down. Dalton Anthony trying to revive McCleary. Pulling Paul Rose up off the mat. Oh, look at that. Big forearm. Follows it up from Anthony. Oh, and a big chop. Oh. All right, that handshake earlier, I think, just got thrown out the window as Anthony does the headbutt. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. That's Brandon Espinosa. What is Espy doing here? Distracting Dalton Anthony.
Come on, Dalton.
That's Paul Rose now. Oh, out of nowhere there. What is that? Two. No, not this way. That's it, folks. The winner of this match, Playboy Paul Rose. Rose steals a victory here, folks. We're going to have plenty more action for you right after this timeout. Well, wait a second. We're going to stay with this. Rose helping Anthony up. Raises his hand. All right, a show of sportsmanship there. Gives him the thumbs up. I don't know that Dalton Anthony appreciates that. be back, folks, right after this.
If you've dreamed of becoming a professional wrestler, it's time to make that dream a reality. The Stride Pro Wrestling Training Academy is now enrolling new students. Classes meet on Tuesdays and Thursday nights from 6 to 8 p.m. for just $60 per month. Be sure to check out the Stride Pro Wrestling Facebook page at facebook.com/StridePro Wrestling and get enrolled now. Welcome back, fans. The Stride Pro Wrestling Tag Team Championships on the line. David Lee Walker and his partner, AJ Kellis, they are the champs, taking on TJ Kellis, who is the younger brother of AJ, and his partner, Jimmy Ryzer. Jimmy Ryzer sends Walker into the ropes, but is met with a shoulder tackle there. Drop down, and a nice elbow and staggers Walker. And there is a flip there. And what is Ryzer going to do next here? Stalking him. And a monkey flip, and Walker is staggering. And look at that, a nice kip up by Ryzer. He's going to head in there again on the far side in a big clothesline. And a bulldog, beautifully done. We may have new champs early on in this matchup. Ryzer opts to not cover Walker and tags in now TJ Kellis. And a big, big elbow across the elbow of Walker, which is already being compromised here. But look at this nice move by Walker as he reverses this now and gets out of it. And now, oh, look at that, Kellis though reversing and going back to that side headlock. The challenger's doing a good job of keeping Walker kind of isolated from his partner, unable to tag into AJ Kellis, who we've documented before a long history developing here between the two brothers, the Kellis brothers. They came into Stride as a tag team and have since gone their separate ways. And TJ often finding new partners to try to best his big brother. Oh, and look at this, a big boom, bear hug into a spine buster and a cover now. And Jimmy Ryzer makes the save. And Walker not happy about that and gets referee Casey Brinkmeyer to put the count onto Ryzer. Now he's doing a little jaw jacking here. Oh, that's going to cost him as Kellis fighting back here. Oh, but then a big thunderous chop. And he is sent across the ring in a front face lock now. Clubbing forearm across the back. And taunting TJ Kellis and putting that throat on the middle rope there and putting all of his weight on the back. Oh, and there's a big splash. That'll take the wind out of your sails in a second. And look at that. More taunting by Walker. And Ryzer steps back in and is quickly being admonished for that. Tag is made. And AJ Kellis now in there against his little brother for the first time in this matchup. Puts the boots to his brother and a big, big clubbing blow to the back. Front face lock here, working him into a suplex, it looks like, yeah. Holding him up high. And down hard onto that mat. Goes for the cover. Only two, though. Kellis and Walker capturing the Stride Pro Wrestling Tag Team Championships back in, I believe it was late August at our show in Gallatin. I'm sorry, not Gallatin County. It was down at the fairgrounds in Pulaski County. A very rainy, wet night. And Walker now stalking his opponent. Oh! Suplex, belly-to-back suplex, hooks the leg. Not enough. And now Walker stopping and then stomping on the hand of TJ Kellis and clubs Ryzer off of that apron for good measure. Kellis fighting back though. But there's no one to tag as we see Ryzer on the floor. He's getting himself back up there slowly but surely. A whip in here. Ducks the clothesline. And Kellis, oh, went for the high cross body, but Walker catches him and big power slam. Hook of the leg. That could do it. That could do a kick out. And look at this. Walker now tagging back in AJ Kellis. And again, TJ Kellis. Oh, they're going to make a wish here. Oh, that is going to hurt. And you can see TJ writhing in pain. And now getting the boots once again from his older brother. And a big elbow right across the chest. Done a good job of working over TJ Kellis here. Limiting his ability to get to his partner, Jimmy Ryzer, and make that all-important tag out. As Kellis just kicks his brother like a dog here. Front face lock, moving back into that corner and tagging in once again David Lee Walker. We're going to get a little double team action here. Closed fist, come on ref, get in there and make a count. Look at this, good gravy. TJ Kellis is out, folks. Look at this, a very nonchalant cover though. He's going to keep fighting. Going to keep going. Has that drive to win his first championship in Stride Pro Wrestling's tag team championship matchup here. Jimmy Ryzer, also a newcomer to Stride, been training here at the Stride Pro Wrestling Academy. You just saw a commercial for that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, ramming him into that corner. And a big kick to the back. Kind of adding insult to injury. And just drops Kellis to the mat. Setting him up here. Slingshot, perhaps. Right into that enemy territory. And Kellis has been taking a beating for several minutes now. And Big Brother is just as unforgiving as David Lee Walker is with this. Of course, they want to hold on to those tag team championships. And once again, blatantly choking TJ Kellis on that bottom rope. And a couple of big forearms for added insult. But look at this, TJ getting a bit of a second win perhaps. Fighting back. And AJ now taking a couple of shots here from TJ, but delivering them right back. These two are going fist for fist, throwing them right here in the middle of the ring. You can see Jimmy Ryzer eagerly anticipating that tag in. He's ready for it, but TJ's going for it himself here, fighting his brother a little bit more here. Reversal. Oh, a big splash there. Hooks the leg. That could do it. A lot of wind, a lot of energy exerted there in that little round by TJ Kellis. Is it going to be enough to fight out of this? Getting dragged back up. He's out on his feet, folks. Rammed in, and once again, and look at this. Smart move by AJ, blocking TJ in. Look at this. This is going to be putting an exclamation point. Oh, but no, TJ moves out of the way. And there it is. There's the tag, the all-important tag here. And Jimmy Ryzer, a house of fire, as he has been waiting on the apron impatiently at times to get back in there. And that's exactly what TJ Kellis needed to get a breather. Rest up here as a big slam was delivered by Ryzer to Walker. And a drop kick. Nicely executed, by the way. Hook of the leg. But AJ making the save. TJ clotheslines his brother over, and the momentum takes him out as well. Referee Casey Brinkmeyer distracted now. Oh, and a low blow by Walker. Come on, don't let it end this way. Don't let it end this way. Oh, folks, that is the end of this one. The champs retain.
So, Dexter, we heard right back there, you're complaining that you haven't had a match for a couple weeks or a couple shows. I'm sorry, a couple shows, because like myself, I wrestle weekly 3-4 times a week, and you wrestle about twice a month. So that's completely fine. Even though you did have 5 this week, I heard you. You did 5 this week, I know. Congrats. But I came out a few minutes ago and cost Dalton his match. And people may want to understand what the reasoning was. And you see, the reasoning is exactly the same reason I have a problem with you.
Do tell.
All right, I will tell. You see, Dalton was starting to get a little too big-headed about how he is as a wrestler. And he thought he was bigger than the tag team between him and Jay Spade. When we all know that Jay Spade was the leader of that team. And you see, every time I am teamed up with somebody over the course of the last 16 years, everyone knows I'm the leader of the pact. Which leads me to my problem with you, Dexter. If you remember correctly in your little manic depression issues you have with yourself, me and you were attacking, you know what, I'm really getting sick of this, thank you. Me and you were a tag team, and I left you high and dry in Cape Girardeau, Missouri, because your head started to get a little too big as well. So, you may not remember it, you may think you have these little side comments and stuff, but you know, that does remind me of another tag partner I had, and you know him very well too, because he's like your best friend. So, with that being said, I think your identity crisis needs to go ahead and halt and be done, and you need to be just like him and just quit the business.
Alrighty, folks, a little bit of confusion happening in the ring as we see right now Brandon Espinosa taking on Dexter Roswell and a newcomer to Stride Pro Wrestling, DNA, and a triple threat match going on, and a lot of jaw-jacking, a lot of trash-talking right now. And look at that. DNA takes both established veterans down here. I don't know anything, literally, about DNA. This is his debut in Stride Pro Wrestling. I am looking forward to him wrestling here as he is taking it to Brandon Espinosa right now. Ooh. And a, ooh, flying clothesline by DNA. And Dexter Roswell immediately jumps back in. And Roswell, as you heard earlier talking, he is the Stride Cup winner, which means he has a championship opportunity at any time. Reversal here and a big drop kick. Some would argue that we did see Dexter earlier, perhaps as Luke Chambers. Some would deny that, but I think we all know better. Look at this, DNA, very quick. And really laying waste to Dexter Roswell. And Espinosa breaks up that pinfall attempt.
And there goes Dexter. He is out of here. And a headbutt from Brandon Espinosa, and rams DNA into that top turnbuckle in the corner here. Big elbow to the side of the head, and there's a second, a third. Pretty relentless right now, not letting up on the newcomer here. Closed fist, it's a right hand. It's enough to put DNA down. But will he keep him down? Again, the taunting by Espinosa here. Looks like Dexter's trying to roll his way back into this competition here. Again, a triple threat match, impromptu. Oh, and look at that. Very wise by Espinosa, throwing DNA into Dexter Roswell. And it looks like they may have conked heads. DNA is holding on to his head, and Dexter is outside the ring once again. And now, Espy kind of taking a break here himself. I don't know if he's thinking about what his next move is going to be, as he's kind of stalking. Oh, and waited too long, and he is out of this competition now, at least for the moment. And DNA may take advantage of the situation here. Still holding his head, though. Oh, and a jawbreaker by Roswell. He's waiting, 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 waiting. Runs to TNA, or to DNA, rather. Hits him with a sling blade. Hooks the leg. That could do it, folks. Between that noggin knocker earlier on and some of the other abuse he was taking from Espinosa, I thought DNA might have been down for the count, but fights his way back up. And Roswell now beating down on the newcomer here to Stride Pro Wrestling. Look forward to learning more about DNA as Roswell stomps on the hand of Espy for good measure. Look at this. Power move. Oh! Beautifully done by DNA, but not able to capitalize on it. That definitely took the breath away from Dexter Roswell. And Espinosa there, you see him. He's stirring. Could re-inject himself into this match as DNA looks to go outside the ring here. Climbing up. And I apologize, the camera is not on this action right now. Whoa! DNA, though, tumbling down. And Espy going up. But Dexter meets him. And maybe celebrating a little early here. Headbutt now. And Espy is perched on that top turnbuckle, top rope. And look at this, DNA coming in now, too. What are we going to have here? Uh-oh, we've seen this before. Oh, powerbomb and a suplex. And I think that took something out of each one of these three men. DNA up first, though. Would be wise to cover Espy. And he does, hooks the leg too. Oh, but not enough. Espy kicks out. Now he's gonna try to cover Dexter. Will it be enough? Hooks the leg, and it is not. What are we going to see here? Espy back up on his feet and gets out of the way this time and rolls up DNA. Nope, DNA rolls through, blocks the kick. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Holding on now, planting himself. Sent into the ropes. Oh, what's it go? Oh! And Espy holding on for dear life here. Oh, but he's driven right into that mat. And Espinosa wisely rolling out of the ring. Catch your breath, man. As Dexter Roswell kicks DNA, hooks the leg, two. Oh, and a kick out. That was close, folks. That was close. close to a three count as you're gonna get. Dexter Roswell setting him up. Blocked though, and whoa, sent in, almost hits Espy. And look at that, Espy pulls that top rope down. DNA goes out, and a roll up now. Whoa, whoa, super kick. Drives his head right into the mat there, hooks the leg, and that's going to do it, I think. Yes, it does. As Brandon Espinosa wins this contest.
And your winner of the match, Brandon Espinosa.
This is not a test.
Alrighty, Espy picks up the big win here, and Roswell is a bit worse for wear, it looks, as Espy continues to stare down his foe here. Espinosa wins. Dexter asks for the mic. Stick around, we'll be right back.
Thank you.
all been waiting for. He needs no introduction. He is Heath Hatton. Team of three, what do you think you can announce that can top this?
Our first member of this team, coming from Salem, Illinois.
Superstar Billy Ray, you were right. I couldn't find anybody. It's what I would have said if I actually did it. All right, so I guess you're all wondering who I picked out for my partners. So with no further ado, let me introduce you to partner number one. Get this match on the road. So here we go. Let me introduce you to Ryzer's partner number two.
Alrighty, it is time for our main event. It is six-man tag team competition as Heath Hatton is joining forces with former partner and rival and partner and rival and Axe Allwardt and of course Shane Rich, all former legacy or heavyweight champions on that side of the ring, facing the current legacy champion, the current No Limits champion in Savveon Ayers, and the current Stride Pro Wrestling heavyweight champion in Ryzer. And we're going to see Roger Matheus start things off for his team. And folks, we mentioned earlier, New Year's Knockout is coming up on Saturday, January 8th. Stay tuned to our social media channels For more details on that show, you won't want to miss it, though. It's going to be a great night of wrestling action as Axe Allwardt starting things off for his team. And of course, superstar Billy Ray outside the ring, joining forces now, seemingly, with Heath Hatton. As well, now we have a young fan up on the apron as well here, getting the moment of his lifetime, I'm sure. As Shane Rich holding up that little guy. And a high five, I'm sure he'll have a great story to tell someday as well, remembering that. But that's the great thing about Stride Pro Wrestling. Fans are able to get up close and personal with the wrestlers, and it's always a great time. I don't think it's going to be a great time, though, for Axe Allwardt, as he's about to go toe-to-toe with the biggest, strongest man on the roster here in Stride Pro Wrestling, and Roger Matheus. And he is jumped from behind by Axe. Axe, of course, seizing every opportunity when he can. Can't say that I blame him. And a big back body drop, and Axe Allwardt goes crashing to the mat. And Roger, with those striking kicks, I can tell you from experience, that is not good at all for the person receiving those blows, those kicks, those strikes. Roger Matheus is all business, MMA background, a veteran of the United States military. As Jim Ross would say, tougher than a $2 steak. Has been in there with some of the biggest, baddest men on the planet, and is just going to not make it an easy day at the office for Axe Allwardt by any means, as now young Savveon Ayers is tagged in. He is the current No Limits champion, and Axe Allwardt have traded that belt. And look at that, Hatton tagged in as Axe kind of cowers away from Savveon Ayers, and these two have a storied history. And look at that, Savveon tagging in the champ, Ryzer, who wants some answers after Hatton attacked him from behind last month. Came in a mask. We have not seen Hatton other than a show at Rent One Park earlier this summer in September. Hadn't really seen a whole lot from Hatton since Strideversary, where he had a very brutal match with Cash Borden. Cash still has not returned from that matchup. And now Shane Rich tagged in here, and I think this may be our first glimpse of Ryzer and Rich in the ring against each other as they lock up, and Ryzer quickly taking control of this match. Again, six-man tag team competition made on the fly as superstar Billy Ray came out and confronted Ryzer during my interview with him earlier in the evening. Hatton now applauding Shane Rich. Different attitudes coming from these guys, and guys who had typically been embraced and loved by the fans. I don't know. I don't know exactly what's going on. And we know Axe Allwardt's history here in Stride Pro Wrestling as one of the most ruthless bad guys, villains, if you will, as Ryzer backs Rich into the corner, but Rich reverses it. What's he going to do here? Oh, he walks away. Okay, okay. Shane Rich, former Legacy champion, had to surrender that belt after being viciously attacked by someone. We don't know who that was. Roger Matheus won the championship belt that night in a special tournament and has been defending it ever since. And he and Shane Rich came to blows just last month as Ryzer now looking good in there and splashes right into Shane Rich. Setting him up now. Big body slam coming up. Driving him into the middle of that ring. Hitting the ropes now. Look at him. Very quick and a big splash. That could do it. Hooks the leg. Only a one count, though. Shane Rich, a well-established veteran here in Southern Illinois and beyond. It's going to take a little bit more than that to beat him, as now he is in the bad corner here and gets to get a sample of Savveon Ayers, is what is he and the champ are doing here. Oh, Rich gets the knee up and catches Savveon by surprise here too. Headlock now. Savveon was a little discombobulated after Ryzer took that knee.
Rich working it. An arm ringer now. Is he going to tag in Axe? Axe quickly got out earlier, but no, Hatton tags himself in. Now it's a little bit of the student and the teacher here, as Hatton, one of the trainers at the Stride Pro Wrestling Academy. You can learn more about that on our Facebook page. And Hatton now with a big right hand, and that was a closed fist, I might add. And a big shoulder block, and there's a second one, and a third one now. He's not going to give this kid any chance to catch his breath. Again, all three champions of Stride Pro Wrestling, all three singles champions of Stride Pro Wrestling, represented on one team. It's Team Ryzer. And Savveon, two-time No Limits champion, sent into the corner, and that Superman punch misses. It's a trademark of Heath Hatton. He doesn't miss that very often. And look at that beautiful arm drag. And a second one by Savveon. And a standing dropkick. And I've said it many, many times, and I'll say it probably many, many more. I love Savveon Ayers' dropkick. He is very crisp in there, and he's come a very long way in the past couple of years as he's trained here at Stride Pro Wrestling. And Hatton very wisely getting a consultation from his partners, as well as superstar Billy Ray. Hatton wanting a timeout, I guess. I don't know. He and Rich exchanging words, I'm sure. Perhaps reworking a strategy, coming up with something new here. I'm not sure. Hatton now asking for a test of strength, which no doubt he will likely take advantage of here, as the veteran. Savveon, though, he's not going to fall for it, or is he? Well, he's going to go for it. He's going to go for it. As they lock hands here. Oh, and Hatton. Man, I suspected that was coming. And I'm honestly, folks, I'm a bit disappointed here. As Hatton now putting that side headlock on. We're seeing a different side of Heath Hatton that we're not used to in Stride Pro Wrestling. A little bit of an attitude, which may work out for him. He wants a chance at the championship. What better way to do that than to kind of change your game? Look at the cockiness, the confidence on his face. Oh, come on now. Being a little ruthless, I think. Perhaps I'm being a little too hard on him. There's a suplex. Hooks the leg. Savveon kicks out at two. Savveon Ayers, though, in trouble, I think, in that wrong corner, as Axe Allwardt is tagged in and kicks Savveon right in the midsection. And that'll take the air out of you quickly, as there's a closed fist by Axe as well, and a knee to the back and a second one. And now just pulling back on that chin and hurting that neck is being contorted and wrenched as that knee stays in the shoulder blade area. Now he's trying to twist his head off like a twist top. Axe Allwardt, ruthless, maybe the most ruthless of the three in the ring, of the three on that side, rather. And an elbow right to the jaw. And Savveon desperately needs to make a tag as that beautiful elbow drop by Axe and then rakes the eyes. Axe Allwardt, of course, the old school warrior. And we've seen so many, shades of Harley Race and of Ted DiBiase, Terry Funk, whoever it is, those old school individuals. And look at that, Shane Rich now choreographing a kick right to the head of Savveon Ayers. Again, these three men, Rich, Allwardt, and Hatton, have experience. They work together, they train together, travel together. And now taunting, Roger Matheus has a couple of young up-and-comers, the future of Stride Pro Wrestling, in my opinion, in Savveon Ayers and in Ryzer, who is the champion. But right now, Savveon Ayers is in trouble and desperately needs to get out of there and make a tag. And there's a beautiful, beautiful power slam that momentum. And I don't think if Roger Matheus wouldn't have come in and broke that up, I don't know that Savveon would have kicked out, folks. It's the referee now being a bit distracted, I think. Being manipulated by the veterans. Come on now, ref. Look at this. Look at this. Hatton now unrelentless and beating on Savveon Ayers. And Shane Rich now throwing some fist at Roger Matheus. Something you don't want to do. Roger Matheus is going to go toe-to-toe with anybody. He is not afraid, that is for sure. And again, this attitude of Hatton's, I don't know, as now a front face lock is applied after a beating from behind, or rather behind the referee's back. Manipulating the situation as best they can. Roger and Ryzer now trying to rally the fans and get some support going. Savveon, he needs it. He needs to make that tag. He's been in there for several minutes now and has basically faced all three members of the opposing team. And look at this. Axe, classic move, distracting the referee. A tag was made, ref. Come on, turn around. Referee Kevin McCleary not seeing it. And now Savveon being beaten here. Come on, referee. I know he's doing his job, but Savveon Ayers, in situations like this, a second official may need to be added to the situation. And look at this, sunset flip, but not enough. Savveon had that little burst of energy, if you will. That adrenaline sometimes gets pumping. You can do things that you normally wouldn't be able to. And look at that, a big, big slam by Axe Allwardt. Calling for that fist drop now. And there's that shade of Harley and Ted DiBiase reminds me so much of those guys. Those superstars, those wrestlers of the 70s and 80s that we grew up loving and watching. Very nonchalant cover. And Savveon able to kick out at two. Man, I got to tell you, I can't emphasize enough. Savveon needs to get out of there if he's going to survive this match. And there's a knee lift. And he is still kind of on that wrong side of the ring. And Axe is going to just continue it here. Continue the beatdown. What's he calling for here? Fireman's carry. Oh, no. Oh, he's putting him up high. Oh, and a smack to the face. But Savveon not giving up. He will not give up. That's what I love about this kid. He's got the heart of a lion. The heart of a champion. He is the No Limits champion. He and Axe Allwardt have exchanged that championship. Axe, of course, the longest reigning Stride Pro Wrestling heavyweight champion, losing it to Ryzer. Heath Hatton has been the heavyweight champion. Roger Matheus has been the heavyweight champion. Shane Rich surely wants to be the heavyweight champion. Oh, look at that. Oh! Savveon able to shift his weight and land on Axe Allwardt and prevent that superplex from happening. And the tide of this match has just turned. And Savveon desperately needs to get that tag. Axe is working his way to his corner. Savveon, make that tag. He's trying. He is dragging himself. Hatton tagged in. Oh, and look at that. Ryzer. And look at this. Hatton is begging off. What in the world? Oh, no. Goes to charge him, but Ryzer, a house of fire. A lot of pent-up anger and rage there as Hatton puts the kibosh on it. But no, Ryzer fighting back. And look at this. Oh, Hatton stomping the foot. And a DDT. Unexpected. And Roger ready to come in and break up the count if necessary. Ryzer was able to kick out. What's Hatton doing? What's Hatton doing? Roger calling attention to it too. The referee not looking at it as well. As Hatton is taking that top turnbuckle off. Come on. Or that pad off. Oh, and look at that. What are you doing, Hatton? He has made the wrong guy mad. These two have had some classic battles through the years. Ooh! And one right hand, and it takes Hatton off his feet. Roger Matheus is a monster, folks. He is just a monster. And look at that, Shane Rich now coming in. He wants some. And this is just a good old slugfest here between these two guys. They do not like each other at all. And now Hatton, rock bottomed, right here, right in the middle. Referee, make the count, come on. Oh, Axe Allwardt breaks up the count as Roger Matheus still pounding on Shane Rich, and Savveon Ayers catching his breath still. Beautiful spine buster, shades of double A there. And look at that. Axe Allwardt going after the big guy, Roger Matheus, as well. After Shane Rich, and he had that big slugfest in the corner. Oh, and Roger puts the brakes on that, fighting Axe Allwardt off. I think he might have got him, though, once. Oh, and Hatton drop kicks him, and head first, face first, right into that exposed turnbuckle. And Hatton celebrating, but gets hit with a sling blade. He's out. Roger and Savveon now are in the ring as Axe and Ryzer battling it outside the ring, and I'm not sure where Shane Rich went. Wait, what's going on here? Roger seemingly thinks Savveon Ayers is the one that kicked him. No, Roger, no, what are you doing? Oh, no, Roger Matheus turning on his own partner here, Savveon Ayers, and Shane Rich now taking the opportunity. An RKO, and the big man is down, and now look at this. Like hyenas, these three are gonna take advantage of Roger Matheus here. Who has, oh, set up, and there's another one. Oh. With that momentum, Roger Matheus is out. Here's Ryzer though, he's entering back into the fray. Big drop kick off the top rope. But look out, Hatton now with a kick to the spine and now stomping down on the champion. And here comes Shane Rich. The referee has lost control here, folks. The referee has lost all control. And the look on the face. Oh, look at that, though. Ryzer, beautifully done. A double clothesline. And he takes Hatton and Rich out. And a rock bottom, no. Several elbows to the side of the head and a side rush leg sweep. The champ is out. Matheus is out. Savveon, not even in camera shot here, folks. This is chaos. This has been nothing but chaos for the last several minutes here. And now Ryzer sent in. And just like a pack of dogs, a pack of hyenas. And look at that. Sent in and then speared. Ryzer is covered. Two, three, and that is enough. Heath Hatton has pinned the Stride Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. You'd think he just won the world championship, but that's not the case. But he's taking the belt. What's going on? You're not the champ, Heath. A victory celebration here. And what's Axe is grabbing the No Limits title? The titles were not on the line here, folks. Rich is grabbing the Legacy, but what? Superstar Billy Ray here, come on, what is going on here? I don't like any of this at all. Folks, I will tell you this, there's gonna be hell to pay come January 8th. And that is New Year's Knockout. Be sure to join us, check out our Facebook page for more details, but it is coming up on Saturday, January 8th as Axe Allwardt, Heath Hatton, and Shane Rich now celebrating a victory. They are not the champions. But we'll get some resolution going on here in the new year. Merry Christmas, friends. Happy New Year. And we will see you again on January 8th.